Now I am going to teach 12th standard physics lesson number 4, content number 4.7.4, AC circuit containing only an inductor. What is inductor? Inductor means a long coil of wire closely wound in the form of spiral shape is called inductor. Current flows through an inductor. The inductor induces self-induced EMF. This is inductor. Then, inductor of inductance L is connected series to the alternating source of voltage. So, the instantaneous value of the alternating voltage is given by V equal to Vm sin omega t. So, now alternating current flows through the circuit. So, current flows through the inductor. The inductor induces self-induced EMF or back-induced EMF. The self-induced EMF E equal to minus L di by dt. From this equation, L represent coefficient of self-inductance. For an ideal inductor, applied voltage equal to opposite to the self-induced EMF. Substitute the alternating voltage, that is applied voltage and self-induced EMF in this equation. Vm sin omega t equal to minus bracket minus L di by dt. So, we obtained Vm sin omega t equal to L di by dt. Vm sin omega t equal to L di by dt. So, rearrange this equation. Di equal to Vm by L sin omega t dt. Integrating both sides of the equation, we get integration di is equal to integration Vm by L sin omega t dt. So, integration di equal to I. I equal to Vm by L is a constant. So, taking outside of the integration, so Vm by L integration sin omega t dt. So finally we obtain I equal to Vm by L omega minus cos omega t plus C. So integration sin omega t dt is equal to minus cos omega into t. That is integration sin theta d theta equal to minus cos theta. So plus C. C is the integration constant. So minus cos omega t equal to sin of theta minus 90, that is sin of omega t minus pi by 2. Substitute the minus cos omega t in the above equation. I equal to Vm by omega L sin of omega t minus pi by 2. Here Vm by omega L is equal to Im, that is a peak current. So I is equal to Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. So from inductive circuit, the current I lags behind the voltage, lags behind the applied voltage by pi by 2 in the circuit. Inductive reactance XL. XL stands for inductive reactance. What is inductive reactance? The resistance offered by the inductor is called inductive reactance. Its unit is ohm. XL is equal to omega L, that is XL equal to 2 pi FL. F is frequency, L is inductor. So time period T is equal to 2 pi by omega. Frequency F equal to 1 by T, that is 1 by 2 pi by omega. So F equal to omega by 2 pi. We need omega. Omega equal to 2 pi F. Substitute this omega value in the XL equation. XL is equal to 2 pi FL. For inductive reactance, directly proportional to frequency. For steady current, F equal to 0, therefore XL equal to 0. Thus, an ideal inductor offer no resistance to steady DC current. This diagram indicates that voltage phase diagram and waveform of alternating current. So, from this diagram, the current I lags behind the voltage, by base angle pi by 2. From this conclusion, an inductor blocks AC current but it allows DC current. Why? An inductor is a long wound helical, that is spiral shaped coil. The steady DC current flowing through the inductor. So already you know very well, current flowing through the inductor is developing magnetic field around the coil. So changes magnetic flux, induced EMF is produced. So for steady current flowing through the inductor produces uniform magnetic field, the magnetic flux remains constant. Therefore, no self-induction and self-induced EMF in the inductive circuit. Since inductor behaves like a resistor, DC flows through an inductor, not allow AC. The AC flowing through the inductor produces various magnetic field, not uniform magnetic field. Magnetic field is varied. Its turns induce self-induced EMF and back EMF is produced. So according to Lenz's law, opposes any change in the current. Since AC varies both in magnitude and direction, it flows in opposite to the L. For ideal inductor of 0 ohmic resistance, the back EMF or self-induced EMF is equal to opposite to the applied EMF. Therefore, inductor blocks AC.